Okay, we made it up to where the roads and the trails end. Looks like we're gonna have to go cross country here to get up to the Pacific Crest Trail. We're over the saddle portion here. Pretty darn high. In fact, my GPS says we're, doesn't say how high we are. How come it doesn't say that? It should say how high we are. It says we're at 5,974 feet. This whole area has been burned out by that fire. But damn, are we high. But that's the trail up ahead there. Right there. We're almost to it. Then we're going to get on it and then go over to the plaque. Well, we just made it. Pacific Crest Trail. Holy crap. I mean, excuse my French. But man, that was a hike up here. I think it's like 1,600 feet, I believe. From way down there. Hi, hun. See? Told you we could do it. Pacific Crest Trail.
What is this, hun?
Huh?
What is this?
That's showing this is the entrance to get back down to where we just came from. That's what these rocks are here for, they're a marker.
So where is the plaque?
Huh? Oh, the plaque is right around the corner there. Oh, that took us forever to find this thing. Okay, we found the plaque on the side of the mountain in honor of J.C. Jenkins, who this mountain's named after. One of the forest rangers who wrote a bunch of books about this area, about the Southern Sierras. And then he got hit by a car at the age of 27 along Highway 14. But he had this mountain named after him in his honor, Mount Jenkins. Well, I'm gonna go back here shortly after our trip to the Mount Jenkins sign. Gotta get back on that trail again and head way down there. Just walking along the Pacific Crest Trail. You gotta be careful. It's a heck of a drop. But it just hugs the side of Mount Jenkins, on the eastern side of Mount Jenkins. You gotta be careful along the way. Whoa. Whoa. But it's a heck of a hike to get up to this trail. About 1,600 feet climb just to get to this trail. Once you're on it, it's easy. Okay, we're about to start our descent again. But to get again to this Pacific Crest Trail, you go to Siebert Recreational Area and you follow these old mining trails until you get to the top of that mound up ahead there. If you can see that big mound right in the center of the screen. And then you follow this ridgeline, those trails end right there, and then you're gonna have to go cross country on this faint use trail. It's a very faint use trail along the ridgeline, straight up the ridgeline until it intersects right here with the Pacific Crest Trail. That's it. It's all uphill, 1,600 feet elevation climb, I'm guessing. Might be 1,700 feet. It took us about an hour and a half to get to the top of it. So younger people probably do it in about an hour. So, but we're heading back.